Hello, hello, friends. We hope this is live. Coming at you from the home studio here in Boise, Idaho. I'm here with Rada.
Hello, everyone.
You'll let me know if this is working, right?
Yes.
If you can hear me, type in the comments and she'll take a look at it that you can hear me. Give it a little time. Thank you so much for joining us again on an EastForest ceremony. Tonight's flavor is called Music for Mushrooms Live. And I just want to say what I have to say right off the bat, just a bit of a disclaimer because of what the culture we live in and so forth, that I can't condone any. Getting delays here, sorry. I can't condone any activity that's legal in your jurisdiction. Mushrooms are legal in a lot of places, and I'm not saying that's what you should or shouldn't be doing tonight. I can't be there with you to advise you or guide you through that experience, but what I can do is offer music and offer a heartfelt sonic space for you guys to dive in however it feels right to you, and that's for your decision to make. But just so you know, ceremony is the kind of thing that we can dive into in many ways, just with our active attention, you know, just sitting with this music tonight and being with one thing, the music, is a very, very powerful act, right? Just breathing. And we're going to take a few breaths together before we begin, but I just want to say hello and say a special hello to our East Forest Council members. That's a new thing we were trying where we met yesterday on Zoom, and we're going to meet after this experience as a way to process and create community. So tonight's timeline is going to be that after this introduction, I'll begin the music here in the space, and I'll do my best to play for 3 or so hours, maybe more. If we have any technical issues, it's just us here. So I'm being my own tech guy at the same time, and I'm more of a musician than an IT person. So if anything happens, I'll do my best to fix it or restart the stream, whatever it is. But we're held right now. We're held. So I feel good about it. And then that'll be that. And we'll end the experience, and I believe it will live on YouTube after that. But it's really nice to be here together and be live all around the world exploring this right now. So this is an opportunity for you to, as we did last weekend, to clear away the noise. There's so much going on, so much change. And I was speaking to the council group, and I thought to myself, you know, this really feels like something new is wanting to be born. And I was thinking of the analogy of when something's like a baby's in the birth canal. It's dark, and it's violent, and it's painful. And you can't see what's on the other side of it. That baby has no idea. It's only known one thing. It was in the womb. And now something's happening. There's a great change occurring. But what's on the other end of that is new life. And from the outside, it also looks quite violent and bloody and difficult and challenging. And it can be touch and go at times. And there's times of elation, and there's times of real struggle. But it brings new life. And my heart tells me that something new is wanting to be born through this process that's happening globally, but also individually. So as above, so below. It's being mirrored in each of us. I know that I feel a lot of ups and downs, and we're all sitting in a place of unknown. And in that unknown can be uncomfortable, but we have to remember there's infinite possibilities. We are beings of infinite possibilities, and there are infinite possibilities, literally, that what's going to happen at any moment. And so we can hold in that truth to say, look, I don't know exactly what's happening or necessarily what's going to happen. And yes, I can do what I need to do to chop the wood, so to speak, carry the water, go get the food you need and the toilet paper if you can find it. But we can put that aside in times like right now to rest and to listen to ourselves, to the deeper, more tender parts of ourselves that I'll contend are always there, but they can be covered up by the noise and the anxiety and the stress. There's some wind chimes, I think from Maui, when I was out with Ram Dass. So when I get into the music here, I'll probably just let the music do the talking. But before we begin this ceremony, or I should say the way we will begin this ceremony is with some tobacco. I've talked to some indigenous shamans who said, you know, tobacco is, if they could have one, like a desert island plant, if they could have one plant, it'd be tobacco. Not because they probably do like smoking it, but I don't smoke it casually. I only use it in ceremony because it's a very powerful plant, is what they're trying to impart. This is just pure tobacco. And I'm going to call in the four directions, and that's something that's been done just about every ceremony back into time. And I like to honor that tradition because I like to remember that the cardinal directions, it's sort of like they create space for us to have our incarnation in. They allow us to have a map, in a way, a territory, for us to be here and then to be there, for us to make choices about where we want to go. And while I'm doing this, I'd like you to think about, where do you want to go? Why are you here tonight? What's your intention with this experience? And see if you can bring it down into a kernel or a phrase, a feeling, a word, something simple that represents all the other things you want to encapsulate to why you are here tonight. And that intention is something that you can gift into the lake of the universe, the plenum around us, and it will cause ripples, and then your job is to listen for the response through the music tonight. Allow the music to create rooms and architecture for you to be in. For you to hear yourself, for you to hear that which wants to speak to you, that you invite in. So I invite in the north. Of courage and wisdom and strength, forward direction. I invite in the east. Of new beginnings, of new moons, of spring, of planting seeds of new ideas. And I invite in the south, of repose, of celebration, of community. And I invite in the west, where the sun sets of endings so something new can be born. Great Mother, Great Father, Great Center. Thank you, tobacco. Thank you to Maharaji and Ram Dass, who brought the paintings in for inspiration. So let's begin. We are now in the space. Let's take a moment to find a comfortable way to lie down or sit, but stay engaged in your body. I encourage you not to cross yourself tonight, to stay a bit open because we're here to receive. We're here to receive and to listen. When you close your eyes, place a hand on your heart and a hand on your stomach. And take a few breaths in through your nose and out through your mouth. Good. Breathing in through your nose and out through your mouth. At your pace, it's normal, it's easy, and watching as you breathe, as your whole parasympathetic nervous system begins to calm down. Good. And as you breathe, you bring your attention to one place, to your breath. You can even think if you want, in, out. You can actively listen by putting your attention too on the sound of my voice, on the sound of the bells, soon on the sound of the music. Very good. Breathing in, breathing out. This is your home base, and this is you. Why are you here? All you have to do tonight is to listen. This is our space tonight. This will not be infringed upon. Visualize a warm golden light in your heart. You can release your hands or keep them there, whatever feels right to you. But visualize as you breathe in this light in your heart that's golden, pure. And as you breathe, it expands and expands and gets larger and larger, and slowly it moves beyond your body, outside the confines of your body into the room. And as you breathe in, it gets even larger and expands past the room, and even larger into the whole building you're in. This is your sphere that will not be infringed upon, that will hold for this ceremony. Golden light. Raining through you, showering through your heart. This is where you can return to at any moment. And at any moment, if you're feeling really high or really low, you can always say, why am I here? And the context of that experience will now be inside a frame. You're not just floating. You placed that pebble of your choice into that lake, and you're here to be in conversation with the universe. Thank you for being here, and thank you so much for your support. And lastly, if the video goes off like this, that just means we're preserving bandwidth, and the video will come on soon when we can. Let's begin.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Suya de lo, Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Bye. Amen. Thank you.
Everything that begins must end. And here is where we come to the closing of our ceremony. Slowly. While I'm talking, recognize again why you're here. Why did you come here today? How does that feel different now than it was maybe before? That ability to choose is sacred. One of the things that makes you unique as a human being. Take a few breaths in through your nose and out through your mouth. Feel the oxygen in your body. Recognize that you're still here now. just where we were before it was now. If you can, put a hand on your heart again, a hand on your stomach, and breathe into your heart again. Recognize the journey you've been on. Recognize that beautiful golden sphere outside your building that's been holding this space for you. Start to breathe it in. Breathe it back into your heart. And breathe it down into the ground. Plant the seed. The seed of choice. The seed of your own consciousness. Your own will. You are light. You are an animal incarnate on this earth. Physical like the rocks, needing sun and water like the plants. Animalistic like the animals. Plus the ability for creativity, consciousness, brotherly love, humor, cosmicness. All of it within your being. That's a tough job. That's okay though. That's what we're here to do. So I want you to be gentle with yourself tonight. And as I close this soon, you might want to put on some more EastForest music or whatever feels right to you. I'm biased. But to take your time, transitioning, take the night off if you can. And tomorrow, recognize that the work continues as long as you want it to. Spirit speaks as long as you listen, as long as you create the space. You can release your hands or keep them there, whatever feels right to you. Let's take in a couple more breaths. Thank you to Radha for holding it down back there. Thank you to Maharaji and Ram Dass. Thank you to all of you for the support. It means a lot to me and it really helps me out in these times of uncertainty and to keep doing what I'm doing. So I appreciate all the donations. It's incredible. More than anything, thank you for diving in. Thank you for doing the work that you do. And all of you, by coming here, all of you answered some kind of calling within you that said, in the words of our friend Charles Eisenstein, that your heart tells you a more beautiful world is possible. A more beautiful world is possible. And I'm going to put forth that we're making it happen every day, every breath, and that there's no destination, there's no arrival. It's just an unfolding. And this is it too. All of this is part of it. So good job. Thank you. Three breaths in, release a sigh on the out, exhale, breathe in. I'm gonna do an om on the exhale if you wanna join me. And so it is, and we close as we begin by blowing some smoke, bringing the tobacco back in. For those of you who were not here at the beginning, we use tobacco as a way of cleansing, but also it's another form of ritual. And ritual and ceremony like this are just ways of telling our heart and our brains and our souls, this is important to me. I want to remember it. This is sacred because we say it is. So, I release the north. And as I do this, you release that which you invited in. You recognize that which helped you through this journey, and you thank it and release it now. I release the east. I release this out. I release the west. All of you, and that brings our ceremony to a close. I hope to be back. If you'd like to hear about more of these, go to eastforest.org and join the mailing list. Or go over to Instagram, Facebook, all those things, East Forest Music. And maybe you can stay tuned in that sense. Thank you again, the council folks, East Forest Council. We'll see you in about 10, 15 minutes on the Zoom gathering.